My name's Penny Kaladropoulos. I've been at Wooranna Park for a long time, approximately 10 years in total. This year my role has been mainly a math specialist role, and that's working with fellow teachers and students in helping to develop innovative and creative mathematics programs and to increase motivation and engagement in the children and to increase confidence for teachers to plan really good mathematics learning and interesting and creating an interest in mathematics. And the theme of our workshop today is estimation, but we will be talking about what messages we want you to get out of our maths workshop throughout the lesson, okay? Some of the session is going to involve you working on your own and using your own ability to answer some questions. But then there will be times in the workshop where you'll be using other resources, such as your friends or the person next to you, or a visual image to help you answer some questions, okay? So the question we want to ask you today, how many states of Victoria's fit into the other states of Australia?
I'm at the finishing stages of completing my PhD at Monash University, and my topic is engagement and disengagement mathematics education. So one of the things that I'm really trialing in my classrooms is how do we create an environment which engages children in mathematics learning? The biggest trick with running workshops, in my opinion, is creating open-ended activities, creating an environment where children feel that they can answer to their best of their ability.
I would prefer working with a partner because then we can work together and then we can find it out together.
Well, guess what? You are going to work with a partner for the next part, so I'll make your life a bit easy. This time what you're going to do is you're going to work with the person next to you. So you might want to shuffle your table closer to the person next to you. And what we want you to do this time is we want you to show your work to your partner. And there's probably going to be a bit of giggling going, what? You wrote seven? No. And we want you to have a discussion with your partner and see if you want to change any of your results, now is the time you can do it. And you're going to fill in your second estimate. So using your partner's information, this is your opportunity now to change your answers.
Now, in a workshop room, obviously you saw we had the chairs and the tables and children were quite lined up facing the front, which appears to be quite traditional. However, I'd like to believe that it was innovative and creative because children were provided with numerous opportunities to work with each other. They were provided with the message that I hope I was clear about, that their answers are estimates and they're only approximate. And of course, the workshop ran in such a way where I not only tried to give them some mathematics skills, but also some just good learning skills.
I just want to talk a little bit about this. Hands up if you found that much easier when you had an opportunity to talk to the person next to you.
I found it easier with a partner because with your partner, you can think about it and then you can easily change your idea because they might have a better idea than you thought before.
So we have proven mathematically that when we work with other people and when we use instruments like maps and stencils and calculators, that we get closer results, don't we?
Yes.
So keep that in mind when you're doing your maths work independently, okay?
Yeah.
Always look out for help, ask each other.
When you provide these opportunities and children don't know if they're right or wrong until the very end, I think they feel less threatened to engage in a mathematics learning activity. One of the things that has really worried me in the past in my experience as a maths teacher and something I've been researching quite extensively with my PhD is maths anxiety in children. And, you know, unfortunately, in this world, many of us declare publicly, oh, I was never good at maths. Oh, I hate maths. And unfortunately, that is said so commonly in parents that it filters through to the children. But children need to understand that everything that is done in mathematics is created through wonder and through interest. And that's how mathematics began in ancient Greece. And I'd like to bring that back into the mathematics classroom where children, and I'm hoping every child in that workshop felt like it didn't matter what I wrote down as an answer because that answer was refined by working with people and understanding, and that is life. And today was an example of children working together to reach an answer. And I hope that what they did is walk away with thinking, now I know how to get to an answer closer when I'm just not sure what to do.